Should you go all in with your goals so you have full focus? Or is it okay to have a plan B? So with goals, it's really important to think about what the purpose is. Because sometimes what can happen is we can forget what the purpose is and we have something that we're trying to achieve. And that's great. It's good to be focused on something. It's good to be committed to achieving something. But sometimes achieving that thing mightn't actually help us. If you're low in a certain nutrient in your diet and you make it your goal to ensure that you get more of that nutrient, that's a good goal. But you may then achieve that goal or your circumstances might change and you don't need that nutrient anymore. So if getting that nutrient is still your goal is going to be out of date. So it's not going to be the best goal to have. Instead, therefore, the better purpose that served that particular goal should be health in that example. And health, of course, can be achieved in different ways and different days or in different months, depending on what our circumstances are. And it's actually possible that something which is really good for you one week may not be good for you the next week if you have very little of that in your system and then you prioritize it and get lots. Great. But now you have lots and you're taking more than you need. And sometimes that's not such a good idea in the other direction. So I think a plan B is a very good idea given that. And it doesn't need to dilute focus if the focus is actually on the core purpose to begin with. I think it's really nice actually to have a plan B. And what that represents is having a kind of a flexibility as to how you achieve your purpose. Because we kind of want, in a way, to be able to quickly give up goals if we find that there is a better way of achieving our core purpose. You know, so we care about health and wellness. We say, okay, as a result of caring for health and wellness, that's my value, I'm going to have this particular goal. If this particular goal works, brilliant. But if you find a better way of achieving the same value, by all means, transition over. There's nothing necessarily wrong with that. You're going to want to obviously do it reflectively and really reflect and make sure that it is actually a good match for you, but definitely worth doing. The other interesting thing about what a plan B can do is even sometimes when the way you're going about achieving something is useful, a plan B can actually help to take the pressure off plan A. Because sometimes the problem is if you're achieving something that's important, and that's plan A, and you're going about achieving that, but what happens then is you think, oh my gosh, this really matters. I have to get this right. I can't afford to fail at this. And that can lead to a kind of a performance pressure. So that performance pressure then, unfortunately, and kind of ironically, because you want it, that's often why you don't achieve it. So then that becomes an issue. So actually knowing that there's a plan B sometimes can actually relax you a little bit more so you feel a bit more comfortable. Now, what this is not to be confused with is just kind of having loads of poorly defined plans going in different directions and not really committing to action and forward movement. It's not about that at all. It's probably something like having gears in a car. And it's fine to have multiple gears. You may or may not use them on a given drive, but when you're in a gear, you're in a gear. You're using that gear. The goal you have or the purpose is getting somewhere to where you're going. How you get there doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what gear it is. Sometimes it might be second gear. Sometimes it might be fifth gear. That's just a product of what the circumstances you're in, what's going on around you, what other motorists are doing, what situation your vehicle is in. All of that comes into play to help make there be a right or a wrong answer to that question. But you don't really mind. You're happy to change gear. You have a plan B, a plan C, a plan D, a plan E. You have multiple gears there that you can move between. So in that sense, it's fine. It's not that you're sitting there in neutral, kind of in no gear because you're hesitant. You're actually very engaged. You have options and you're engaged in whatever gear is the best one for you. So yeah, I think when you're doing a bit of goal setting and a bit of planning like that, ask yourself, what is the core thing you're trying to achieve? What is the real purpose? What's the value behind what you're doing? And then say to yourself, okay, what's plan A here? You know, what's the most likely way of achieving this as best I know? And maybe what is a plan B and what is a plan C? Move into the gear that you feel is best. So out of your multiple options, name plan B as the one that seems to be the best fit. It's the most compatible with who you are and where you're going, with the circumstances you're in, with the resources and the supports you have available. So you kind of engage in that as plan A, but you have those other options if needed. And then as you continue to drive, you stay in the gear that's working for you, but you're also feeling and sensing how the drive is going. And then if you need to transition between gears, that is absolutely fine and reasonable, and you're welcome to do so. If you found this valuable, do like, subscribe, and share. And what's your experience? Do you have any questions or topic suggestions? You can contribute in the comments, on social media using hashtag bodymindself, or on jfl.com.